Welcome to the Swans Show, your weekly update on all things Swansea City. Coming up this week, we catch up with a true Swans hero, Bryan Flynn, and we meet the Argentinian branch of the Jack Army. But first, it's a Ferrie Christmas for the Swans Show as we sit down with fans' favourite, Ferrie Bodde.
I had a really good feeling when I was here, really good memories, the best time of my career, apart from the injuries, of course. But no, I met some really good people. The club culture is really my how I think about playing football. And I'm always looking for what the Swansea is doing. So no, I'm really happy to be back. So the last time when I was back in August, it was really strange for me that when I come at the stadium, people come to me for an autograph. And it's really nice, but at that time you take it, how do you call that? Something for granted?
Yeah, take it for granted, yeah.
And but it was really nice. The way he talked about football, he was talking as a player about football. And we had such a click. It doesn't matter if it's now Amateur League or Premier League, I want to play for him. And the first feeling is always important if you come here at the club. And they do such a good thing up here at Swansea that if a player comes here, they give him straight away the family feeling. And this is, I think, also a little bit Welsh, but that makes this club big and always, you know, always have good things. And the one goal was back in the League One. It was that they give me the way I think about football and give me that feeling to survive, weet je, into the game. I get a kick on my knee. It was against Walsall at home. I get a kick on my left knee, piece of bone, you know, yourself through my skin. And Martinez came to me and said, I was going to the line. It's Ferrie, come on, score and I take you off. I said, Gaffer, I cannot go in. Ferrie, look at me. Do it. So seriously, and at that moment I go in, I get the ball, I make action, I shoot with my left in the low corner, really nice goal.
Yeah.
And nobody remembers, but I remember. And that was a really nice goal and a really important 3 points because we had a few draws before. And so that was the most memorable nice goal.
Did the manager take you off like he promised to?
No. One day it was like we talking, boys, how many passes we had this game? For example, 544. We want to improve that one. So one game we were 1,000 passes, small passes. And during the game we make jokes. Just small passes in 2 meters, 1 meter, tick, 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 tick. During the game, after the game, always was a good feeling. And I think that's what this team needs now also at this moment. The best player is difficult because I do. Every player got this.
Qualities.
Had his special qualities. I was not the midfielder if Darren Pridley or Liam Witt was next to me, but the same for them. Jordi Gomez came in. He makes us more complete. Joe Allen, you know the way Joe Allen goes. We make us all complete, and we were not the same players. We got a box-to-box midfielder. We got a little pit bull. We got an architect. We got a skillful player. And if you mix that good and you do only what you can, then I think there's a good understanding. And then, but it's difficult for me to choose. And if I have to choose, I'm gonna go for Gary Monk. Just because of he gave me so much goosebumping moments in the huddle. I was never for a huddle like you know, but this one was good. He make a good story every game, and that makes us unbelievable. That's the moments that I appreciate. Now maybe I needed to take my injury more serious, and I thought I did it serious. But you know, you can never turn things back, of course. But no, I don't regret that also because I had a good time, and hopefully get more memories of this club. So.
Do you remember the game against Birmingham City very well, where the injury first happened? Do you remember the moment and your emotions at that time?
Yeah. Yeah, because a few days before that game, I get a message that says, you know, you're gonna get involved for the Dutch national team. as you play like this, and because Dutch national team had a shadow team, you know, like if one fall off, they go off B.
The B team.
Yeah. And I was already invited. After that game, I should be invited, and there were a few clubs. Not that I was planning to go to another club because I want to step up with Swansea, but at that time I was thinking, so I'm doing really well. What we are doing really well, and I just want to be involved with this team. And I start off really good, assist and play some balls, but then I had a sprint. I was quicker than Larsen, but he did a strange movement, and I went all the way, and he stepped back, and then it's click. But that was not because of him, it was because of I was playing 12 games on a row with an injection in my stomach for my thing, because I wanted to play football, and that broke myself a little bit down. So that's if you talk about regret something, that's maybe I needed to take more rest at the time. But if you feel yourself good and important for the team, then you step over it and you do everything what you can.
Bryan, you've a book out, Little Wonder, the story of your career in football. It's a good tale, isn't it?
Yeah, very good, very good. I've enjoyed reading it. It's obviously a biography. Leon has worked tremendously hard to put it all together over a period of now 12 months, and there was a bit of a panic on to get it out before Christmas, but thankfully it's here, and I hope people will enjoy it. It's everything. Yes, it's from my early days at Burnley, when I went up there from 10 miles down the road from Port Talbot up to northeast Lancashire. My Burnley days, my Leeds days, obviously then going into management with Wrexham, obviously Wales, and up to date now.
You weren't at Swansea for very long, but it was a crucial spell in the club's history. Do you have fond memories of that time?
Yes, and but some people remind me for the wrong reasons, for surviving. You know, is surviving successful? Well, in that case, most certainly it was, yes, because of the predicament the club was in, and it was obviously very pleasing. It's been a milestone in this club, that's for certain, and it's still in the memory of a lot of Swans fans, I must admit. There must have been 40,000 there in the Vetch. I most certainly can say there was at least 10,000 on the North Bank, and officially, I suppose, only 4,000, I think. But it was nice to remember. It was a dream day for one James Thomas, wasn't it? A dream day he could never imagine he would have in his football career.
But. And you must be proud, not just of steering the club to survival, but bringing those players in who would have such a big influence in the years that followed.
Yeah, they have, and they've all had good careers from different spheres. 15 years ago this week we signed Leon. Some milestone that is, isn't it? And he's here now, and he's helped both hopefully on the field and off the field to secure our place in the Premier League.
And you're still playing a part now at the club, of course, in your role as part of the scouting team.
Yeah, and obviously an important part. We feel, I think, recruitment from day one for me as a from playing. It's exciting looking for players. We all obviously are in a certain market. You know, we're not in the £50 million market, but we're in a good market, and there are some good players out there, and I've identified quite a few.
As we talked about, you know all about a team in trouble, pulling clear of danger in the end. Do you see some happier times ahead in the next few months?
Well, I'm hoping so. I think we've got to look at, most certainly, people being patient. That's absolutely vital at this stage. If people start to panic, then the trouble becomes really serious. If they're patient, if there's a plan, and I know there is a plan, both on and off the field, then we can survive.
The Swans ended a 7-game winless streak as Wilfred Boney scored his second goal in a week to beat West Bromwich Albion. In midweek, however, Paul Clement's men became the latest team to find out just how strong Manchester City are as the leaders won comfortably at the Liberty. Swansea City have followers all over the world. This week, four Argentinian members of the Jack Army trekked all the way from Buenos Aires to the Liberty to see the Swans in action. The Swans Show went along to meet them.
Hello, my name is Benjamin, I'm 23 years old.
My name is Lucas, I'm 24 years old, from Buenos Aires.
I'm Nicolas from Argentina, I'm 23 years old.
Hi, my name is Francisco and I'm 44 years old.
Tell us how far you've come today to watch this.
Well, we came from Argentina, it was a long trip by plane, then by car here from London, and it was difficult with the traffic in the motorway, but well, we arrived
just in time
and enjoyed the match, a difficult match, but well, it's nice to be here.
Really. Tell us why you wanted to support Swansea, why you wanted to come here.
We know each other since high school, and since we were about 12 years old, and well, we knew Lucas, and we knew his fanatism with towards Swansea, and then he started, and then we joined a Twitter page from Swansea, Argentina, that was the link between us and the club.
I dreamed to be here, well, we dreamed to be here, and now it's possible. I want to thank the club, of everyone who helped in the press, and well, everyone to make this possible.
Sorry.
Not only is from us, it's from the club too.
What makes you want to come 7,000 miles to watch Swansea City?
Well, it's years supporting the team, and start everything with the way the team played, with Rogers, with Laudrup, then with Monk, and then you don't know and you make support of a team and a supporter. Well, it's in your skin, it's in everywhere.
We were in high school and it was Lucas all the time talking about us, about Swansea, and it started like first like a show, and we start getting involved with the club, and all of us started following the club and the results. So first Lucas start talking about the club and how big the club is, and then we start like being more
involved
and passionate about the club. So it's a nice story.
What's it meant to be here and to watch the Swans live?
Well, it's awesome. He planted like a seed that, well, it's grown and we are here. It's difficult to believe it, because it's also our first trip
together
in Europe, not only here in Wales and in the Liberty Stadium. So it's like a very mixed sensation. It's awesome.
And is there a big Swansea following in Argentina?
Yes. Well, I told you that in the south, in Chubut, is a community of Welsh people, that in Gaiman, it's called Gaiman, and there are a lot of Swansea supporters. Also in Chile, Brazil, it's special, it's different. It's the thing you watch every week in TV and be here, the environment, everything is different, it's special.
We get to see it so near, back in Argentina, the grades, the stands are so away from the players. And here you can have it like 2 feet away. It's mad.
Come on,
Swansea!